All right, everyone, welcome back to yet again another prospect pool overview. And today we are moving on today with the Vancouver Canucks. So Vancouver is a pretty interesting team. They have some interesting players here in their pool still. And even though they're already a young and pretty exciting team, even though they're in a different spot than other teams right now, they still have a pretty decently sized prospect pool with some decent good players in it for sure. And I like Vancouver's pool a lot because they got some underrated players in here. And they got guys that, you know, people may forget and they don't talk about, but we're going to bring some light on them today. Starting off with Jonathan Lekkerimäki. He's a right wing from Hunjing, Sweden. 5'11", 172 pounds, a little bit shorter than other players that were drafted in his class. He won the UAT World Junior Gold in 21-22, so of course he has some hardware there. He was drafted 15th overall in 2022 by Vancouver. And I remember when he was drafted, I remember that he was projected to go higher, but then he fell to the Canucks. So I like Lekkerimäki a lot as a pick there. Really solid right winger this past year with the Jew Gardens IF/J20. I included the stats. He played a combined amount of 31 games, 5 goals, 9 assists for 14 points with the Jew Gardens IF/J20. He's profiled as having an NHL-ready shot and will likely take the next step to the AHL next season. So, of course, we'll find out what Lekkerimäki's potential is in the AHL this coming season. And I think he really could impress some people out of training camp and maybe even get himself a spot on that roster. It's very possible. So yeah, Lekkerimäki, I like there a lot as a solid up-and-coming underrated prospect there for the Vancouver Canucks. Next up then I have Linus Karlsson. Linus Karlsson, more of a not that well of a known player, but he still is pretty notable. And he actually could make an impact next year with Vancouver. It's very possible. He's a center slash right wing from Esko, Sweden. He's 6'1", 169 pounds. So Vancouver, and actually I just realized, like, a lot of these prospects are from Sweden for Vancouver. So they really like their Swedish guys. And they're just trying to, you know, get with Elias Pettersson, of course. But Linus Karlsson, drafted 87th overall in 2018 by San Jose, was traded to Vancouver for Jonathan Dahlin, I believe, a few years ago. And this past year, he played with the Abbotsford Canucks, had 72 games, played 24 goals, 25 assists for 49 points. I like Linus Karlsson there a lot, had a really good year with the Abbotsford Canucks. And he seems like a player that is really on the rise and is another guy that really could impress some people out of training camp and could maybe not make an NHL roster, but could actually get some playing time with the team, with either the Vancouver Canucks or, of course, Abbotsford. But yeah, I like him a lot. The only concern I have is his skating. Apparently skating is a big concern for him, but he has taken strides in that area to get better. So of course, that is good news to hear that. But yeah, I like Linus Karlsson a lot. And I will say this too. I kind of forgot some prospects in Vancouver. I just realized talking about this, I forgot Elias Pettersson on the defense. I included two defensemen that aren't the Elias Pettersson that we know. And I don't even have him listed in the other prospects, so I apologize for that. Canucks fans, but Elias Pettersson, I did not forget about him, the defenseman. I did not forget about him at all. But A2 Ratti is my next guy for the forward core. Ratti's a center from Oulu, Finland. He's 6'2", 287 pounds. Ratti, and I've talked about Ratti so many times on this channel, he is a guy who, you know, kind of fell off the edge of the earth. Every year progressing towards his draft year, he kind of started getting lower and lower in the rankings, eventually where he was taken, I think, in the third round, I believe. That's 22nd overall is definitely not right, but I believe he was taken pretty far into the draft in 2021, by the Islanders, and was of course traded midway through this past season, from New York in the Bo Horvat trade. So he actually did play some games, with the Islanders. He played a total of 15 combined games, with the Islanders and the Canucks this past season. Although he is not he's not considered a NHL regular yet. He is still considered a prospect by my regulations. It's 30 games or higher. So, of course, Ratti still is classified as a prospect. That's why I'm talking about him here. In 52 games combined with the Canucks and the Islanders, he played 52 games, had 9 goals, 18 assists for 27 points. I thought those were all right stats for his kind. I think it was his first season in the AHL. I thought he played okay. And, I mean, it's not the biggest thing in the world. But, of course, guys like that are still going to take time to develop. So that's another big role there. Like, and that's what I've been saying a lot with these prospect pool overviews and talking about these guys. some of these players may take a while for them to take that next step in the NHL. So that's why I'm thinking with Ratty, his development's been a little bit slower, but I definitely think he will have a positive outcome with the Canucks if he makes the roster next season. But I think next year could be a make or break year for him. Of course, we'll find out. On the defense, you have Tom Willander, the guy they selected in this past year's draft. Defenseman from Stockholm, Sweden, 6'1", 179 pounds. He won the J20 SM gold medal in 22-23. He was drafted 11th overall by the Vancouver Canucks in 2023. And I remember that as being a little bit of a stretch, but I didn't hate it at all because Vancouver needed a defenseman. So I liked it a lot for them. And, I mean, they could have gotten Zach Benson. And I know that's what a lot of people were complaining about. Believe me, I was too. My team passed on Benson as well. But I like Willander a lot. He's played with the SHL, has that experience. With Rogel BK, J20/J18, so some more combined stats. He played a combined amount of 39 games, had 5 goals, 22 assists for 25 points. I thought those stats were okay, were very good for a defenseman for sure. He has high-end skating and is engaged defensively in plays, which is something that as a Canucks fan you would definitely need. So I like getting a guy like Tom Willander there a lot. For Vancouver, and I think he's a good acquisition. And again, I forgot about Elias Pettersson. I would have put Elias Pettersson in this spot, but instead I put Akito Hirose, brother of Taro Hirose of the Red Wings. He's a defenseman from Calgary, Canada, 6', 170 pounds. He's actually undrafted. He was signed by Vancouver, and they took a little bit of a risk getting a player like this, but I think they made out better than they thought they were going to, because Akito Hirose is actually a really solid defender and played well with Minnesota State. Playing 38 games, had 4 goals, 23 assists for 27 points, and even played some time with the Canucks too. So definitely, it's good to have a guy like that who's had some NHL experience too get under your belt. So I think Hirose could potentially compete for a defensive role there with Vancouver, but of course we'll find out come training camp. What happens, but he can create some great offense via transitioning, and I think he could be a great forward or great defenseman there on Vancouver's blue line, but he may need the year in Abbotsford. It wouldn't be a bad thing at all, but of course, we'll find out what happens there. Finally, I have Artur Silovs of the goaltending position. He's a goalie from Riga, Latvia, and he's one of my favorites because Latvia, I love Latvia. He's 6'4", 216 pounds, drafted 156 overall in 2019 by Vancouver, and he actually is looking like he could be the backup. He really looks like he could be the backup to Thatcher Demko, or even the starter if Demko leaves. He could be that guy that rises up. And he played 5 games this past year with the Vancouver Canucks and had a 3-2 record, a 2.75 goals against average, and a .908 save percentage with Vancouver, which I think is great for him. And then this past year with Abbotsford, he played 44 games, had a 26-12-5 record with a 2.44 goals against average and a .909 save percentage. So I like Silovs a lot there. He put up good numbers in the AHL, was actually pretty good in the NHL too. So definitely could be the likely backup next season, especially with Spencer Martin being your backup, and Martin doesn't have the best track record in the world. So I think Silovs could get that opportunity to be the backup heading into 23-24, and I really hope he does. There's not a lot of Latvian presence out there in the NHL, and getting a guy like him in Vancouver's pool is definitely great. Other prospects that are in the pool for Vancouver, of course, defenseman Elias Pettersson. I missed him on the graphic, but he also have forward Josh Bloom, Cole McWard, center Danila Klimovich, and forward Aiden McDonough as other notable prospects there in Vancouver's pool. So yeah, that does it for this prospect pool overview of the Vancouver Canucks. Thank you all for watching. I can't remember what team we're doing next, but I know we're doing another team soon. But yeah, as of now, tomorrow we're probably going to do a rookie review, and then we'll get back to the prospect previews or prospect pool overviews after that. But anyways, thank you all for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Adios.